Hey YouTube hikers, here's my gear video from PCT Section H. I'll put a link to that in the description. This is a Stone Glacier Evo 3300 pack. You can put items between the pack and the frame. I emptied all the food out of my gear closet, put it in the earth sack that's on the bottom. And on that black bag on top, I have heavy items. Everything in the bag is pretty lightweight. This pack I use because I do things like pack raft and I have a stove tent, so sometimes I really load up a lot of weight. Sometimes I even carry wood up a mountain for a weekend with the tent stove. Anyway, earth sack full of all the food in my gear closet, and then heavy items on top like any metal items, cook kit, batteries, anything, liquids, heavy stuff is between the pack and the frame, and then lightweight stuff is in the pack. It's really comfortable. You can carry a lot of weight. I was 55 pounds, and my base weight's probably 15 to 20. So here it has an opening. This isn't how I had it packed. I just did this quickly for a video. So there's my water kit. It's 4 ounces, I think. Yeah, you put salt water brine in the middle there where it's bubbling. You can go 1 to 20 liters. It gets rid of viruses and bacteria. So, like, put a handkerchief over the opening of your bottle so you keep debris out, and then just use this chemical filter. Real simple. I got, like, a 1.5 liter smart water bottle and then a cap from a different smart water she can drink without having to untwist it. I got 2 water bottle holders on the backpack straps for this trip. That's basically the water kit. Real simple. Usually you can get clean waterfalls on these trails in Washington, PCT trails, and I don't always filter, but play it safe. So yeah, this belt pouch has what's called a grim lock there. It's a little clip, little reminder for me to keep my zippers closed so I don't lose things. And in here is that water filter. It's solar powered. It has a flashlight, rechargeable with micro USB. It has a brine bottle. It has 2 storage containers. That's a removable belt pouch, so if you want to make the pack lighter, you can get rid of these. So solar panel on the back, 2 salt storage, USB, and then a flashlight on bottom. I've had this a long time. I use it on every trip, pretty much. Always comes with me. And then there's a little, I'm getting ready to pull out a hydro whirly pack, I think. It's a bag, like, I think it's a 1 liter bag in case I want extra water, at camp. So that's the water system. The pack I showed on the scale, I think it's 5 pounds because I have a lot of extras attached, but it doesn't feel like it. It's super comfy. There's some diarrhea pills in case I do get bad water. Keep them nice and handy. And then on the other side, on the other belt strap, is another one with hydration, another grim lock, so I don't lose things. I get tired when I'm hiking and I lose things, so I like to have these little safeties, keep everything captive. Salt chews, they keep you hydrated so you don't just sweat and pee. Some more that have vitamins in it. So that's my shelter. It's 4 pounds. It's actually, that's my shelter, my sleep pad, everything. My quilt. So I just weighed everything individually. It's like 2 pounds, 1 pound. There's a sleep system in a waterproof bag, 2 pounds. There's what the tarp looks like. It's a hammock tarp with doors, but I use the bug net underneath. The MLD bug net weighs like nothing. You can pitch a tarp in various ways. This whole trip, I mostly cowboy camped, actually. But you can pitch the tarp so you can see the stars, or you can see out in the woods, or if you want to keep warm, you can. I usually use straps. So this strap is for shed hunting. You can hold antlers on the back of the pack. They're really strong. But the pad there, I have like an Amazon food bag if you want to keep something warm or cold, or use it as a foot box. where you can put your arms in it. You can do lots of stuff. It's a sit pad. And then I have a Chilo Gear backpack pad, just a random one from one of my Chilo Gear packs that I use for my lower body. And then the Gossamer Gear Nightlight, I think, pad. It's like 7 ounces. This is like the lightest, most minimal. These go underneath the bug net so I don't poke holes in the ground sheet. Really comfy, really light. I have a Nemo tensor I use if I don't mind carrying more weight, the long wide one. But I was pretty comfy with this. So that's the pads. I think it weighs a pound. Goes underneath the bug net, which you saw. Goes on the back of the pack. That aluminum bag also protects it if I walk under blowdowns or branches, so I don't rip holes in my pads. And those are all, like, waterproof, closed cell. MLD bags got my anchors in it, tent stakes, which I use if there's not trees. And if there's trees, then I use the cords. The cords have Dutch wire, little worm hooks and stingers and wasps and all those things, the hammock things. That's normally in the front. But, yeah, you can see I lost some footage because my phone battery was full and the file was corrupt. But, anyhow, that's poop kit. This bag is a mesh bag. I have the tarp inside of a snake skin, so it's easy to deploy and put away. And then another Dyneema sack. The other thing with this Dyneema shelter is it doesn't absorb water. If it gets wet, you just shake it off. And then that's an extra pad, just random pads. Since I have such a minimal pad, if I have like something bony or a rock, I'll just stick these pads under a hip bone or a elbow or knee or whatever. And then this is a purple case that I think my purple mattress sheets came in. But I put that, it's a real comfortable, like, high-density cotton, high thread count. I put it around that Hyperlight bag with random stuff in there, like socks and some pieces of quilt, like square pieces of quilt or whatever. And that's my pillow. And then I keep my shoes inside the bug net. You prop your elbows up on them. These are little tips I got from the Backpacking Light book and Gossamer Gear site. There's the ursack. This is usually what camp looks like. Food sacks hanging up. And here's an example with trek poles, no trees, and stake to the ground to keep warm. This is a little valley by Mount Adams. It's kind of chilly. I was also looking at the stars. You can flip half the tarp over if you want to watch the stars at night. I saw a lot of shooting stars. You can see the Milky Way. Here I had the tarp, the pullouts, so you can see how spacious it gets in there. If you use the pullouts, you can stretch those walls out. If you want to peek outside, you can just do that. I always have a ridge line underneath to hang clothes or to hang the bug net. That's with the tarp up higher to let some wind draft through using the guy lines instead of the stakes to the ground. There's bungees on all those anchors so you don't rip your tarp. A couple more shelter pictures. So again, this is, I think it's a 4-pound system for everything. It's a DIY quilt that I sewed for a sleeping bag. 13 ounce, I think. So, yeah, I try and gather food. I was eating huckleberries, dry, cold soaking, things like oatmeal and earth sacks in between there. Inside, I use odor-proof bags and, like, a chip holder to keep it shut. And then I have another bag inside of there for trash. This was mostly full of, like, dehydrated, powdered foods, oatmeal, stuff like that. Some snack bars. Just a variety of food I needed to use up. So I fried tortillas. I got powdered pancakes, powdered eggs, dehydrated hash browns. I got cocoa mix and bone broth soup. So I have two stoves. The Tato Gear on the left, that's a 1210 caldera stove inside the Vargo. You can use wood. I got a bunch of stuff there. You can see the two pot holders on the left and the lid, long spoon. This is another cook kit. I had some ghee butter. Another way to cook is to just cook the food in the pot like those Nora meals, or just boil water and dump it into a backpack pantry to hydrate. I got a little Snow Peak plate there. Doesn't weigh anything. I dehydrated some apple chips. There's the windscreen and tinfoil. This is my rain and pajamas. I got a poncho and some surf gear. Emergency stuff. There's my Z-Pax chest bag. Knife, GoPro, GPS, random stuff. I was just weighing batteries. Another belt pouch. I had Band-Aids in there. I had Dyneema gloves, mainly to, in case my hands got sunburnt, which it didn't. Or if I get, like... This was the first hike of the year I didn't prepare, so sometimes I get, like, blisters on my hands from the trek poles. I had goo. And somebody gave me this flavored water thing. It has some vitamins, I think. Tastes like Kool-Aid. That's more Band-Aids and whatnot. And the zippered part, I have, like I said, some Dyneema gloves, mainly for sun, to shield the sun. I got my poncho in there. Stuff I might want to grab without pulling my pack off. And, yeah, those are just some nice cheap gloves. Some clips and whatnot are in there. There's the Z-Pack. So it has a strap if you're in town, and then it clips. You can take that strap off and it clips to your front of your chest and your pack with some different clips. There's the poop shovel wet wipes. Comb for the beard. Got deodorant. Got a little box full of, you know, little things. Got another bag. Durable bag. Waterproof. This is a temperature probe. You can use it as a tent stake. And I always get curious what temperature it is. Straw. Random stuff that glows so I can find things in the night. There's a sheath to a little... A pinch knife, which I lost on the trail. I got a compass there. I got another compass on my watch. I use the GPS to find sun up and sundown, trying to make sure I find a camp. I don't keep that charger in there. It was just thrown in there. Dental floss. Scope, which I use when I brush. I got two of these little headlamps. An extra battery, some clips. Leuco tape and a thing for blisters I found at one of the hiker boxes at the gas station. Whatever. Depends on the trip. I put different things in there. Sometimes I put my water. Oh, there's an Nalgene that fits in those water bottle holders too. It's got a human gear cap, wide mouth cap on it. Sometimes I'll put powdered food in those. You can see the packs open and opened up. There's a quilt. There's a DIY quilt. Some synthetic down booties and a down balaclava. And then I made some squares on the quilt. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Like I said, this pack is, I think, 5 pounds with all the accessories on it. But it's so comfortable when you load it up with weight that it's worth it. I don't know. I think if I was doing a thru hike, I'd even take that pack. But maybe I'd get a bigger bag on it. So I don't have to have things in between. But I don't mind. It's kind of convenient to be able to pull bags out from between the pack and the frame. So yeah, I mean, I'm mostly ultralight. This pack was 55 pounds with all the food and liquids that I brought. But I'm probably under 20 or even under 15. Considering all the shelter and sleep systems, 4 pounds. Pack's 5 pounds. And I can make my cook kit pretty light and my food lighter. I think I weighed the rain gear and other things. I kind of had some extra stuff in there, but I was pretty comfy. And I'll put links in the description to some of these things I was talking about. That's it, boo-boo.